kind of new to this YouTube thing. My name's David. I'm owner-operator along with my dad, Landworks Excavation. We've been doing custom work and site prep and land development for about 18 years. And I thought maybe you guys would like to kind of see some stuff that we do day to day, so I'm going to be kind of letting you in on a little bit of what that is and the aspects of what we do, what's involved in all this crap that's going on out here with everything, and just a little bit of what the project is that we're doing now to start with, I guess. But as you can see, we're kind of in a swampy-like mess. Of course, it's winter in Tennessee. The biggest BS crap you can get, because it doesn't get cold, it doesn't get hot, it just stays in purgatory swampiness. This is one of the retention ponds on this site that we're building right now. It's not finished yet. Pretty much anything that's in red dirt and stuff like that still gonna have riprap on it. They want these ponds to retain and hold water throughout the construction process. We're building, this is a 60 acre site. It goes way over there. It's gonna be 59 homes here. It's a housing community. We're responsible for, well, in this stage of it, we're responsible for the roads, the utilities as far as the water, ditches, retention ponds, anything to do with the initial erosion control. Well, anyways, there's four of these ponds. This is one of the smaller ones. There's going to be one here, one directly across. That's a drainage ditch running through there. These two are almost mirrored of each other, and we have two other larger ones that I might be able to show you later on up front. Like I say, this one's not complete yet. It's still got to have the riprap, and all this has got to be sewed down right here. But they want these to hold water throughout the construction process so that any sediment will fall to the bottom and then allow just the water to tumble over the berm that's inside. It's going to be riprap. And then it's supposed to have another riser on the exit tile over there. We've not got that in yet, just simply because it won't quit raining long enough for us to even do it. But what we're doing today, though, is not much going on because it's too wet. We just got some rain, I don't know, yesterday, I think, and they're calling for some more tonight. But we're going to take these three pieces and move them up front, because we are going to, on the road, starting at the very beginning, this whole side is intersected basically by four creeks that cross it, and it bisects the property, and you can't even get back here really without, well, it's too swampy. So what we're going to do is we're going to build the crossings up with shot rock or filter stone or whatever you want to call it. Just so we can bridge the crossing so that we can travel the property and start getting usable clay and things like that, and to build everything up to grade. But anyways, just stay tuned with us. Let's see what's going on.
Jeez. Got my cat hat. I'm not cat sponsored, that's for sure. I sponsor them a lot.
I just did there and they had that dang thing in the crib. It's been a good one. I've had lots of yetis on my crib.
Yeah.
all day, but we've got that out of the road now. You can kind of see that's where the road is starting up there. And pretty much about right in there is where we got to start our undercut, and every bit of this all the way through here, at least to, well, I don't know, probably about that point right in there, has got to be all undercut and filled with rock. But you can kind of see the path of the road as it continues on through there. It is definitely a mess. We're supposed to get another half inch of rain tonight, and I think another inch of rain later on this week. But it is what it is. We'll get her done somehow.